I heard some news about Miss Miley Cyrus. She had to make a trip to the hospital. It wasn't super serious. She's okay. But she had to check out her tonsillitis, right? Mm-hmm. But in going to the doctor, she found out that she had to get some other things checked, in which she had to go down for vocal cord surgery.
Wow.
So I want to throw this question out to my talk show host friend here. Miss Miley Cyrus had to refrain from talking for weeks.
Yeah.
So I want to ask, how long, if you had to zip it, could you last?
It's actually very common. It's called vocal rest. And even Celine Dion has been known to do this before concerts. They'll go days without speaking at all.
How long can you do it?
I could do it. So you guys know that I love my time alone.
Yeah.
And just recently over the summer, Israel was out of the country. And I got to be home for 4 days by myself. I never left the house. I never talked on the phone. I never spoke out loud.
And you loved it?
It was the most beautiful moment ever. Like, you have to remember, we talk for a living.
Yeah.
Like, sometimes I just get tired of hearing the sound of my own voice. And I know you do, too. So it was great. It was for both of us.
Yeah. Yep.
It's true.
I enjoyed it. I just stayed home.
I'm an introvert. I'm naturally an introvert. But at the same time, this happened to me when I was doing Sister Sister. I thought I was Celine Dion. Thanks, guys. I thought I was Celine Dion, and I formed a nodule on my vocal cord.
Oh.
And if you know how you get a nodule is from yelling and screaming. So I was doing her high note thinking I was singing, but I was actually yelling and screaming.
Yeah. It's like and a callus on
it
your
is.
Vocal cord.
Yeah. Yeah, and I wasn't allowed, you know, to talk until I had to do Sister Sister. So if you look back at some episodes, you can see, like, I have a really, really, like, raspy voice. It was kind of sexy.
Raspy. Rhonda, real sexy over there. I feel it.
But I was frustrated because just because I can't talk doesn't mean that people don't stop talking to you.
Oh, right.
That part,
you know?
Right. Mm-hmm.
And it's like you wanna respond, so I had to like write everything down, and it's just frustrating. Yeah. And now imagine I have kids, you know, how am I gonna yell at Aiden and Arai when they're doing something wrong?
Yeah,
you know?
On a whiteboard.
Yeah.
Stop.
They can't yelling or something like that.
Yeah.
You know? I don't know, and I love to read to them at night.
Yeah.
So that would be frustrating.
It's not happening
in
the house.
No.
Nope. You're gonna stay talking.
Well, you know, people always say, they think that when they say, oh, vocal rest, that they're kidding, that, you know.
No,
that,
I don't care.
Your voice is very important.
Yeah.
Especially as a performer. Even with me, I do maybe 5 to 6 shows on a weekend. And I have to know how to control my voice because, you know, I sing at the very end of my...
You
do? Yeah, yeah.
What do you sing?
You have to go and see it, okay?
I didn't know this.
Yes, I sing, but see, I know how to sing from my diaphragm.
Oh,
you know,
okay.
So that I preserve the vocal cord so I can come back on Monday morning and say, welcome to the ring.
Ah.
Yeah, so, but it's a trick to doing it. And you just need to take care of no matter whether you're a performer or not, you know, try not to smoke. Try not to, you know, get rest. Take care of yourself, gargle, all that kind of stuff. It'll be good for you. Now,
what about you, Jeannie?
No, I love communicating. When I'm by myself, it's easy. It's easy to be quiet by yourself. But when you're around people, I don't know if it's just my personality that I want to interact or if you guys think I always want to interact, which is cool too, because I'm on a talk show, so you think like I got something to say all the time. But when you're at the airport, you don't realize how much you would rather not be noticed and rather not talk to anybody.
How long could you go without talking, Jeannie?
I could go without talking for 3 minutes. I would think that.
That's an honest answer from you.
Because I feel like you're very like self-aware, and I could totally see you and I like going to a monastery and just being like quiet.
Yes, you and I would
like,
love it.
Take a vow of silence.
I don't know why these heifers are lying on this table
totally
today.
I could see that.
I would check myself in and just be quiet.
Really?
Now, wait.
Swear it to you.
Wait, for how many days?
For like 3 or 4 days.
No,
but here's the question, though.
You can't be quiet for 3 minutes. She just admitted it. You winner.
It's because they pay me.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
And it has to be with your phone or not. Like, I just ask, could you be okay on those 4 days without your phone?
I need a book. Something. I need something.
Stimulate this.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, I wouldn't want to sit the whole day just scrolling through it. And like, no, I'd want to have like a book. I'd want to like do self-work.
Yeah.
I'd want to like have a moment. I love it when they say sometimes when you're quiet, you can actually hear God or like take a moment to hear your own thoughts. And that's what I think would be beautiful.
Yeah.
Silence is golden.
Shut up, Lonnie.